Have you read this one?
Nope. Oh, yes, yes, yes.
Anything to declare?
Yes. No, no, no. No, nothing to declare, no. Nothing in my suitcase, no.
No, watches, cameras, radio sets?
Oh, yes, four watches. No, 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 one watch. No, no, not even one watch. No, no watches at all. No, no watches at all. No, precision watches, no.
Which country have you been visiting, sir?
Switzerland. Oh, no, not Switzerland. Not Switzerland. Began with S, but wasn't Switzerland. Oh, what could it be? Terribly bad memory for names. What's the name of that country where they don't make watches at all?
Spain?
Spain, that's it, Spain, yeah.
Label says Zurich, sir.
Yes, well, it was Spain then.
Zurich, sir, Switzerland, sir.
Switzerland, yeah.
Switzerland?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Where they make the watches.
Yeah. Oh, nice shed you've got here.
Have you got any Swiss currency, sir?
No, just the watches. Ah, just my watch. Just my watch. My watch on the currency. I've kept the watch on the currency and I've watched it and I haven't got any.
That came out a bit glib, didn't it? You got the alarm clock in there, sir?
No, no, heavens no, no, no. Just vests.
Sound a bit like an alarm clock going off.
Oh, they can't have been. It must have been a vest. Going off.
Going off.
What? I confess I'm a smuggler. This old case is crammed full of Swiss watches and clocks. I'd be perfectly trying to deceive Her Majesty's customs and excise. I've been a bloody fool.
I don't believe you, sir.
It's true. I'm guilty of smuggling.
Don't give me that, sir. You couldn't smuggle a piece of greaseproof paper, let alone a case full of watches.
What do you mean? I've smuggled watches before, you know? I've smuggled bombs, cameras, microfilms, aircraft components. You name it, I'll smuggle it!
Don't, please. You're wasting all time. Look, for all I know, sir, you could have bought these in London before you ever went to Switzerland.
I wouldn't buy 2,000 clocks!
People do. Now, close your watch. Put them along, please. Go on. Don't waste our time. We're out there. We'll catch the real smugglers.
I am a real smuggler! I'm a smuggler, everybody!
Thank you,
man. Do you understand? I'm a smuggler! I'm a lawbreaker! I'm a smuggler!
Poor fellow. I think he needs help.
Right, cut the wisecracks. Go get the search room and strip...
Well, to discuss the implications of that sketch and to consider the moral problems raised by the law enforcement methods involved, we have a duck, a cat, and a lizard. Now, first of all, I'd like to put this question to you, please, Lizard. How effective do you consider the legal weapons employed by legal customs officers nowadays? Oh, while you're thinking about that, I'd like to bring the duck in here and ask her, if possible, to clarify the whole question of currency restrictions and custom regulations in the world today. Perhaps the cat would rather answer that. No? Lizard? No. Well, let's ask the man in the street what he thinks.
I am not a man, you silly Billy.
I'm not in the street, you fairy!
Well, speaking as a man in the street...
What was the question again?
Just how relevant are contemporary customs regulations and currency restrictions in a modern, expanding industrial economy?
Oh, never mind.
Well, I think customs men should be armed so they can kill people carrying more than 200 cigarettes.
Look, I think that nobody's gone abroad should be allowed back in the country. I mean,
Blimey! Blimey! If they're not key enough to stay here when they're here, why should we allow them back? And the taxpayers' expense? I mean, be fair. I mean, I don't eat squirrels, do I? I mean, well, perhaps I do, one or two, but there's no law against that, is there? It's a free country. I mean, if I want to eat a squirrel now and again, that's my own business, isn't it? I mean, I'm no racialist.
I think it's silly to ask a lizard what it thinks anyway.
Why?
I mean, they should have asked Margaret Drabble.